Wonderful change is coming, and it's coming your way. Good morning, good morning, good morning. This is the day that the Lord himself has made, and certainly we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Happy Wednesday to all of you. Glad to have you aboard on this morning. We are blessed of the Lord and certainly highly favored. Thankful for this hour, because in this hour, this is an hour where we have our time of prayer, our time of intercession, our time of impartation, and man, it is just a blessing for us to be able to connect with you each morning, myself and Ree, and morning, Ree.
Good morning.
Blessings. Let's get Sister Val in here as well. Good morning, Sister Val. Blessings
good
to you.
Good morning.
Bless God. Yes, indeed. This is the day that the Lord himself has made, and we certainly rejoice, and we are glad in it. We are thankful. We are blessed. And let me see if we got the bishop on. Bishop, good morning.
Morning, Mitch. How you feeling, sir?
I am well. Thank God that we have you connected as well on this morning. And the songs say, a change is coming. It's coming your way.
Yes.
You got to declare that thing. You got to decree that thing and know that it's surely going to happen, and it's going to happen in your favor.
Yes, sir, and it's going to happen, matter of fact, not long. It's going to happen right now. I believe something is turning even as we speak it, bitch.
Talk to us this morning. Yes. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's coming. It's coming. It is coming. Bishop, thank you so much for being with us. And Bishop Avery Austin is the proud pastor of Total Deliverance Church, Little Rock. And we are certainly honored to have him once again with us on this morning. It's a blessing to have you take us to the throne of grace, share words of life. And the Total Deliverance Church is located at 415 West 12th Street, right in the city of Little Rock. And so, again, Bishop, thank you for being with us on today. And we await that you have for us on this morning and to share in the name of the Lord.
Bishop, over there in 2 Kings chapter number 4, there's a familiar story. We often tell it about a widow woman who comes to Elijah because the creditors was at her door, and she said the creditors was come to take her sons to be bondsmen, but her husband had died. He was one of the sons of the prophet. She came to demand of God, and I need you to do something for me. And this woman in this particular narrative of Bishop, she was desperate. She was looking for a blessing. She was looking for a way out of her problem. She needed a life-changing blessing that was going to change her entire life. And she comes to the prophet. And let me just say something right now, because if there's something that we know about God, that he's in the business of turning things around. He's in the business of making the bad things work out for our good. He's in the business of taking whatever the devil meant for bad to turn that thing around for our good. I just hear the Lord saying right now in my spirit that it's being overturned. Ooh. I don't know, somebody under the sound of my voice, I want you to hear me and hear me well. God said is being overturned. The diagnosis from the doctor is being overturned. The judgment is being overturned.
My God.
Whatever is coming against you is being overturned.
Yes.
Where there's sickness, there's going to be health. Where there is lack, there's going to be abundance. Where there's been sorrow, joy is coming. Where there's been confusion, peace is coming. Where there's been loss, God says, get ready, get ready, get ready, because restoration is coming. Everything that the devil stole, he got to turn that thing around. The man of God told the woman of God, said, what do you have in your house? She says, I ain't got nothing but a little oil. This is what I want somebody to understand. Don't you dare underestimate the anointing. She said, I ain't got nothing but some oil. He said, go borrow some vessels, and don't you borrow a little bit, borrow a whole bunch of them. And then I want you to come back when you get the vessels, close the door up on you and your son, and then begin to pour that oil. That little oil, begin to pour. I want somebody to know to underestimate the anointing, because God anointed you to win. You've been anointed to come through this. I don't care what your this is. You've been anointed to come through this. This will not break you. This will not kill you. This will not hold you, because you've been anointed. And the Lord said he's overturning it right now.
Jesus.
Out that thing, bitches. Somebody put in the comments, if you want to come and reply, and say it's overturning for me right now.
Yes.
My
God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Woo.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, God. Thank you so much, Lord. Bishop. Powerful words of encouragement and life on this morning. Thank you so, so much. And somebody needed that word.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody needed that on-time word. A great lead into the throne of grace. And we believe in the power of prayer. And Bishop, if you would be so kind, take us, sir, to the throne of grace.
Father, we thank you for your goodness, your grace, your loving kindness, your tender mercy. We thank you for being God all by yourself. Now, God, as we fastly approach Resurrection Sunday, there are some dreams that have died along the way. There are some visions that may have died along the way. There are some marriages that may have died along the way. God, I ask you in the name of Jesus to restore, to resurrect dead hope, resurrect dead dreams, resurrect dead visions, resurrect dead families. In the name of Jesus, let your people know that you are the God Almighty, and beside thee, there is no other. Lift up the bowed down head, encourage to discourage, and bind up the brokenhearted father. In the mighty name of Jesus, there is no God like you. Satan, you a liar. The Lord rebuke you. The blood of Jesus is against you. And I command you and every demon and force, they've been assigned to my sister. They've been assigned to my brother. I command you in the name of Jesus to drop your weapons, abort your mission, flee back to the pit of hell from which you came, for you will have no victory here. For I declare and decree that in the name of Jesus, it's being overturned. In Jesus' name we pray.
Hallelujah.
Amen and amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank
you, God.
Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
God, I need you.
Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb of God.
You'll be pleased with my life. With whatever I do, now I realize what I need you. God, I need you.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, I need like the sun is the west, in order to set.
Yes, Lord.
With all
hallelujah.
The worst, you can't have the best.
God.
No good without bad, without work it won't last. That's how I see it. I won't take it back. So please, please.
Wait a minute, Bishop. Wait a minute.
This one
wait a minute.
Request. Oh, Lord, I need you.
Bishop Avery Austin. You want to see him chiming in this morning? Those powerful words. Reese rocking. Sister Val is over there rocking. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
No strings, I'm doing my part. You can have all of me. Nothing will ever come between. Lord, I need you.
Mr. Boston, thank you again for your time of sharing on this morning. Take a moment to share with our listeners how they can connect with Total Deliverance Church.
I need everybody under the sound of my voice. If you in the Mid-South region, I said the entire region, you got to join me this Sunday, which is Resurrection Sunday. You got to join me this Sunday at the Total Deliverance Church. That's 415 West 12th Street. Total Deliverance is the church located downtown Little Rock on the corner of 12th and Broadway. Service time starts promptly at 10 a.m. Now listen, listen, beloved. Don't you come there looking boozy. Don't you come there with your heels too high that you can't give God no praise. We the wrong kind of church. But if you want a wang dang doozy, I'm talking about the Holy Ghost pouring out. Preacher might not even preach. You got to meet me this Sunday.
Jesus.
Yes. Located downtown Little Rock. On the corner of 12th and Broadway.
Listen, Bishop, we heard you loud and clear. Thank you so much, sir. We appreciate you.
Bishop, I'm fired up. Bishop, I'm fired up. It's resurrection, baby. I'm fired up.
Hey, listen, we understand. We just thank God for Big Mama.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Huh. At least we know where you got it from. Praise the Lord. All right, Bishop, blessings to you, and we'll catch you on the next Wednesday, and we just pray a powerful Resurrection Sunday service for you and your church family.
For you as well, Bishop. Love you, sir.
Yes, sir. Love you too. We're gonna be dancing over at Lamb City of Life too. I understand. Three, bam, morning, hold on, coming up.
You kept me through dangerous and unseen. Now you've been so very good to me. I don't know why I'd be without you, G. I dance because I have been set free. Oh, dance.
Dance, my baby, dance.
Come on and praise.
Praise my way to my breakthrough.
Oh,
so, ladies and gentlemen, we got Bryan Popin coming up. We're going to be talking with him live. So do us a favor. Make sure you share. Can you share with 10 people now? Let me get my 10 in. Ladies, let's get our 10 in.
Your compassion, your grace and mercy is why I dance. I have been set free. Oh, dance.
Dance like David dance.
His blood, we've been redeemed. I am no longer bound, no chains holding me. I dance because I'm free. Everybody dance, do your dance. Everybody dance, come on, let's dance. Clap your hands and dance.
Like we dance.
Come on and praise.
My way to my breakthrough.
Dance,
my way to my breakthrough.
Dance,
dance,
That's the awesome sound of Marcus Jordan blessing us in song on this morning and everybody dance. What'd you say?
We just dancing like David did. That's all.
and you know what? And everybody ought to know how to dance because all you do when you get saved, you just kind of switch partners, right?
I guess so. Yes, yeah, that's pretty much
yes,
it.
Yes,
yeah.
That's it.
You get a better two-step, though. You know, that two-step hit different, you know.
Yeah.
You get a different two-step.
Yeah. Moving with the melody
then. Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah, the beat different. Yeah, when the beat drops, it's a little different.
Well, we're going to drop this morning hope note beat. Can we do it?
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. You know, there's a lot of people walking around in life feeling guilty, ashamed, because they're not quite where they want to be in life. And you know, we can be our biggest critic. You know, always thinking that we're never good enough, don't have the potential or the resources. So this morning, I hope note is a reminder. Yeah, Brother Craig, we're going to talk about the master because he's still at work. The master is still at work. Yes, Lord. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. My God. It's easy to get down on ourselves because we're not as far along as we want to be. Yeah, we focus on our flaws, our shortcomings. Why am I not more disciplined? I'm still struggling with this addiction. I'm so impatient and I keep saying things that I know I shouldn't say. Some people live with this nagging feeling inside telling them that something is wrong with them and how they just don't measure up. But the scripture says that God is the potter and we are the clay. Yeah, he controls the process of when and how fast we change. See, the key is to accept yourself while God is in the process of changing you. Yeah, you're not supposed to go through life being against yourself, overanalyzing your faults. Focusing on your weaknesses doesn't help you improve. No, all that does is slow down the process. Yeah, we put all of this pressure on ourselves to change. I have to be more focused. I gotta watch my mouth. I need to be a better mother, a better spouse, a better employee. Now it's good to want to improve, to strive for excellence and to grow, but don't get frustrated if it's not happening as fast as you'd like. No, only God can change some things. And until he gives you the grace to do it, you have to accept yourself where you are. Yeah, it takes maturity to have peace in the process. The Apostle Paul says that we are God's masterpiece. My God, a masterpiece. Now, it's interesting that a masterpiece never makes itself. No, without Da Vinci, there is no Mona Lisa painting. Just an ordinary canvas some paint, brush, it's no big deal. And without Michelangelo, there's no statue of David. Just another big slab of marble. Now others looked at that marble slab and thought it's nothing special. See, the difference was the maker. Hey! Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. The good news is that you have a maker, you have a designer. Yeah, it's not Michelangelo or Da Vinci. See, your maker is the Most High God. And it's not up to you to become the masterpiece. That's your maker's job. Yeah, you don't have to strive, perform, and live under pressure. You can relax. Yeah, relax, knowing that you're a masterpiece in the making. Now, you may have some flaws, some areas that you need to do better in. You're not finished. The master's still at work. Yeah, don't get discouraged while you're being changed. No, your divine designer can see the finished product. And he's making you and molding you. Yeah, he knows exactly what you need. He knows when you need it and where you need it. What looks like a mistake or a flaw, what looks like a mistake or a flaw to us is not to him. Nah, when when he's added some more strokes, a little bit more color, a little definition, more shadowing, it'll all begin to make sense. When it all comes together, you will become the masterpiece God created you to be. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Awesome, awesome. Thank you so much, Sister Val. What a powerful, powerful, a powerful morning hope note. Thank you so, so much. And wow. That's good. That's good. That's good. Well, ladies and gentlemen, sisters and brothers, before we do our morning check-in, we got some special guests that's going to be with us. We want you to know about it, and well, we've been talking about it, so, and we're so, so excited about our special guests coming up here inside of Fred Harris and the Morning Brew. Listen to this right here. Listen, listen, listen.
Yeah.
How can I explain the things you do?
How can I explain?
How can I explain the way you work it? My soul from doubt, and I could have failed, I could have died, I could have lost it all, but you made it.
wait anymore. I can't wait anymore. Let's get him in here.
But somehow you still.
It's the new release of the man himself.
Thank you.
Favor and Mercy. And ladies and gentlemen, sisters and brothers, Ree and Sister Val, let's get him in here right now. He's live and with us, Mr. Bryan Popin. Let's send a shout out. Good morning, sir. Goodness. How are you doing?
Good morning. How you gonna play that on me like that this morning and me not feel nothing? Woo!
Right.
Listen, it's hard not to feel something. You've got some hits out. You got some awesome songs that's out. And first of all, let's say welcome, man. We're so glad to have you. You had such an impact on our lives when you came to Arkansas during our Rejoicing on the River event. It was so powerful. And I mean, I had old folk, my mom, Lady McFadden, one of the ministers here, she said, "You know what? I enjoyed the whole concert," but she said, "That Bryan Popin."
The mamas. I always get the mamas. Well, I like her. You tell her I love her. Give her a big hug.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, what is going on with you? Walk us through your journey. And maybe there's someone that's viewing, because we've got viewers from different places. Talk a little bit about you and your journey. Bryan Popin as a young man and aspired at some point in his life to do music. Man, you play, you sing, you do it all, you produce. Talk to us.
Yeah. I mean, so I was just being ministered to you. Or by you, you know, when you're ministering hope. I mean, so many people need that, especially in today's world. And there's been many times in my life when I felt looked over, passed over, forgotten. And even at times, you know, I had to get my knees on the ground and cry out to God and say, you know, God, do you remember my name? And just like Samson, like, God, don't let me rely on my talent. Don't let me rely on a gift or a melody maybe that you inspired, you know. I need your anointing. I need your heart. I need your will for my life. Don't let me think that I did this ever. And then don't ever like me not know that your hand is not on my life. I mean, that's crazy. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, during the pandemic, I had a number one with Beautiful Savior, with Tasha Page Lockhart. And I should have been really crazy busy traveling, hugging on people, ministering to people, and just doing what we do live. But I was stuck home and kind of trapped. Mm-hmm. My dad passed, who was my best friend during that time, and I became quite angry and frustrated, you know. And then to see my brothers and my sisters and people that I've loved on and believed for have so much hurt and pain from past and from people that did them wrong that honestly I didn't even know about. You know, growing up in New York and New Jersey, it's just a melting pot of people, and it's very different than the South, and I've lived in the South for quite some time now, but that broke my heart, man, and it just really broke my heart and taught me to love more, to have more compassion for people, and to kind of be like Jesus with skin on, man, and just, you know, go after people and love them, because there's a lot of hurting people in the world, and one by one is all it takes. But as I was in that mindset, you know, just a lot of feelings were going on. And I sat down with a pastor friend of mine, and he just said, "Man, remember when God did that thing for you?" And I was like, "Yeah, how did you remember that?" And he's like, "Oh yeah, I remember that." And I was like, "Well, remember that one time when, you know, you did this and blah, 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 and that should have happened, but that didn't happen." He's like, "Yeah, man, I remember that too." He goes, "Why are we still here?" And we just start almost crying. And we're like, "If it was not for the favor and the mercy of God," because like anybody that's listening right now to what I'm saying, you know, you might be questioning this or that or frustrated or confused, but you're still here. That's and if right. you're still yes. here, then yes. you still have a testimony. You still are a witness, and God is still going to use you. So you may feel looked over or passed on or whatever it might be. But trust me, do not give up. Do not give up. Because if he called you, then he'll appoint you at the right time. And you know, that's what that whole song, Bishop Fred, man, Favor and Mercy is about, man. Just so thankful, so grateful. I could have been sifted. I could have been taken out. But God.
But God.
My God. Yes.
Listen, you had to be man. And there is always a story behind the glory. And man, we must tell you that the glory certainly reigns in that song. Every time we hear it, it's not just a song. It's not just a beat. It is all of that. I mean, you feel it in the words. The words are just so powerful. Walk us through the lyrics from your heart. I mean, we heard it in the song,
but it means a lot. I mean, you're just to hear you say that, because this song has been a slow process and a bit of a struggle just at radio, honestly, because it's not as funky and upbeat as Step in the Name. It's not as, you know, old school church choir as I've been through the fire, but I got out, you know, it's not that. It's not even like my first single, which became like a theme song for a lot of people. I mean, it was first a word of encouragement for myself that I can make it, that I will get out of the mess of life that I was in. So many different scenarios. I was pretty much tanking head first in my marriage, in my ministry, in my career, and even in my family. And I had to reprioritize. But again, God gave me his grace, gave me his favor, gave me his mercy. And I'm just really thankful to be able to even talk to you right now and to say that my marriage, you know, 24 years, happily married now, 6 children. I'm just so thankful because God is a God that can turn things around. Sure. And that song was birthed in my heart. I can make it, right? It just started with this little vamp. And it became a word of encouragement for me and then a theme song for like Bishop Jakes and a lot of other people. And, you know, I think that in general, that's why we can't give up during hardship, during pain, during struggle, because those are times when God really speaks to us and ministers to us personally. And we think it's for us. And lo and behold, it's for somebody else, you know, whether it be a family or a friend or the masses. And I've learned that, you know, this is way bigger than me. So at times when I want to quit, at times when I'm like, man, I believe in this song, Favor and Mercy, but like radio wants another funky, upbeat church choir song. You know, why is this, you know, what's this wall, whatever. And now to see that it's breaking after just, you know, trusting God and believing and being steadfast. We're all in this thing.
Oh, wow.
Together, regardless of what you think or you see or a lyric that you hear me sing. You know, I'm not the greatest singer. And I think in general, that's the beauty of it, is if God breathes a melody from heaven into my heart, and if I can sing it, then I think anyone can sing it. And that's the whole point of this, is to connect, you know, from my heart to your heart, from my spirit to your spirit, to the spirit of God.
Well, I'll tell you this, even the children can feel it. Because when it comes on for praise and worship and whatever rendition we're doing that's based off of yours, it just, it's almost like it opens your heart for you to be able to receive whatever is next.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's beautiful.
It is definitely that. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for telling me that. Thank you.
Amen.
So, Bryan, how old are you, if you don't mind us asking? They told me not to ask ladies.
Oh, no, that's cool. I'm 46, so man. I've been in full-time ministry for 27 years. All I've ever done is music. Started as a concert pianist in my teens. My mom wanted me to go to Juilliard. I was living in New Jersey. Then I met a producer who was dating Chaka Khan, who was best friend with Stevie Wonder. And I just kind of clicked with him. And he's like, man, let me mentor you. And let me teach you what real music is all about. I'm like, oh, okay, you're going to teach me real music. And he did. I mean, he like introduced me to Kim Burrell and James Cleveland and, you know, some of the old cats, Rahsaan Patterson and Bootsy Collins would come over and record bass. And I mean, he just taught me a lot of things that, and I honestly fell in love. I fell in love with the sound of music. I fell in love with the heart behind music. And then ultimately I fell in love with the genre of gospel music, because it's about heart and pain, struggles, but we look to a bigger source. We look to God, and I needed that in my life. And, you know, I think you strive towards anything you want to be like and you love. And I just really fell in love with that sound and that culture. And, you know, that's why you can't take that out of me.
Yeah, God did that because you.
Woo, yes, he did.
You've been around amazing people and had an amazing career already. That's a blessing.
Yeah, it is a blessing. It'll make me. So many times, though, I'm in a room where I feel like I don't belong, and I'm in a room next to people I don't have the credentials and I don't have the history to be there. But I just, again, look at it like God saying, you know, this is what I can do for you. I can put you in a room where you don't belong, where you don't deserve. So
favor and mercy.
You know, when we first recorded this song, I told the singers, because I work with a guy named Aaron Lewis, who's like Kirk Franklin's MD and James Fortune and a bunch of other people. He's working on Dr. Bobby Jones's new live project right now. But Aaron's like my brother, and he's so gifted. He's so talented, but he's an old school church cat. So he brought in our singers that we usually use, and we sat him down and we're like, now listen, you know, this is a little different than what you're normally doing. This isn't like a train that's just going somewhere, but we just want you to feel the heart behind this song. And we sat and we just played him the demo for it. And little by little, I started looking at the singers and they start tearing up. And Sam Franklin was there and she starts crying. And I'm like, we just start hugging on each other because that's like the story of it all. You know, like if it was not for God, I don't even know if I'd be here. I shouldn't have my wife right now. I shouldn't have any money right now. I mean, I've messed things up so much, but God.
Yeah.
You got that right. None of us should be here right now.
My God. Yes, Lord.
Wow. And your heart, your passion, your journey, your love for the kingdom, and you saying, you know what, I don't mind putting it all on the table because my experience is real, but so is the favor and the mercy that God has placed on my life, and it's bigger. Yes. It's bigger than the tests and the trials, and man, we're so excited for your triumph.
Thank you.
You and I will tell you this, with the little that I know and the few 30 plus years that I have been doing this, this song is major. It's not just another song, but it is a mantle to be placed on the hearts of anyone that is going through and anyone who just need to hear that heavenly sound again. And man, that favor and mercy, it's the David of a giant that resonates. Yeah. And so thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you for allowing, because a lot of times persons go through things and they won't allow the penmanship to resonate. But man, it is resonating. It's shining bright. This yellow color, it represents the song.
Yes. Well. Thank you.
Yes.
I'm tearing up, man. I mean, it's like, you know, I've been through a lot and a lot lately and still struggling now. So thank you. That means a lot.
And you belong wherever he places you.
Thank you.
Amen.
I've been trying to see when I can get a pair of them shades.
No,
I've been
he's going to
take them. I don't need them. I don't need nothing anymore in life, man. I wear contacts and I got sex in the vibes. I pulled over to do this interview, so I know,
man. Oh, thank you so much.
You be rocking the shades.
Yes.
I love you guys. Thank you for your contribution. Thank you for playing the song, supporting it. Thank you for your words of encouragement. I mean, you know, they're not just words. They're very meaningful. And thank you. Thank you for sharing that.
Yeah, we got to get you back to Arkansas. And also, before you go, take a moment, man. It's always, we love to take the opportunity for you to just share with persons who are trying to make it happen, who are trying to do it, those younger aspiring artists. Sometimes there's older ones who have kind of lost the way because, you know, they felt many times they were next in line and they just kind of put it up, you know, put up the keyboard, put up the instrument, put up the pen and say, you know, I'm not going to write anymore. Speak to those individuals.
Wow. That's deep because I heard a friend of mine say, his pretty well known, but went through some struggles, that he had a keyboard in his apartment in New York City. And there were times he would pass it by because he's led stadiums, he's led large churches. And he was just struggling internally about some things that he had done to himself and his family and just didn't feel worthy anymore. And he would pass by the keyboard and God would say, you know, just worship me, just sing to me. you know, like way back, like how it all started, just sing to me. And he'd be like, nah, I don't feel like it. I don't want to. And that's where his heart was at the time. And there may be some people right now that feel like that, that feel burnt out, bitter, frustrated. Just, you know, they don't even want to use their gift anymore. Maybe it's church hurt. I mean, whatever. But little by little, God was peeling layers off of his heart. And he was a worshiper at heart. And so, lo and behold, at like 5 a.m. in the morning, he started sitting down at that keyboard and just worshiping. Not performing, not trying to create, you know, pitch an album or a single. Just worshiping. Mm. Worthy is the Lamb. Jesus, you know, just worshiping. And from that, God totally healed his heart, restored his ministry, restored his family, and restored his mindset to the fact that he's still a child of God, regardless. And so, again, I just want to encourage anybody that might feel that way, or somebody that looks passed over or looked, you know, beyond, because I know a lot of artists, they're like, well, when is it my time? Well, if God gave you the gift, then he's going to give you the song. He's going to appoint you at the right time. I feel like that at times as well. But a lot of times what I think is going to be sometimes is not how God wants it to be. Mm-hmm. And he uses a song as a way to minister to, you know, a friend of mine. He uses a song as a way to minister to my mom. He uses a song to minister to me. He uses something to minister to the masses, but it's not always that. And a lot of times life, it's a test. I mean, yeah. I can remember, Ms. Fred, I remember back in the day, I used to go do gospel festivals, and I'd roll up and I'd just start, you know, hooking up my stuff. And then I would have artists say to me, hey, man, brother, man, I need a quarter inch line. Or, hey, man, do you have power? Or, hey, man, do you have that? And I'm like, oh, my God, they think I'm the sound guy. And, you know, that's humbling, but I laugh at it now because look at the journey. Like, I didn't give up. I didn't quit. I could have. That could have ticked me off so much and, you know, just put me in my place, pride, whatever. And the enemy maybe wanted me to quit back then, but I kept pursuing, kept going on. God kept blessing me. Years later, I went back to, you know, some of those same events, and the sound guy now is a guy that had a song out called I Got Out, or A Step in the Name, or I Can Make It, or Favor and Mercy, right? And then people were singing that song, hugging on me, and the journey's a beautiful process. So again, just enjoy the process rather than always wishing, you know, man, I wish I was here, or I wish I was there. Just enjoy the process, because God works during the process.
I like that.
Yeah.
I really love that.
Man,
it's encouraging.
I'm telling you right now, you're coming back to Arkansas. That's just
about I better.
I'm bringing you back.
Yeah,
I
better.
We're going to bring you back. Yeah, we got to make it happen. And thank you for taking out the time. Thank you for the song. Thank you for your heart. Thank you for your journey. We celebrate your journey. You know, it's bad to be broken, but it's a powerful thing to be mended, know you're mended, and to be able to take that mending and put it in a song for millions to be able to hear. And I will tell you, this song will not be placed on the side, but this song is at the top on many person's shelves, and it's on the top of our shelf. And we're not saying that to make you happy. We're saying that because it is the bottom line. When we hear this song, it resonates so powerfully. And I'm gonna tell you something. Late in the midnight hour, this is a song you can be. I'm talking about late in the midnight hour, man. Get in the car and just put the song on repeat, because I will tell you, you can put some miles behind you listening to Favor and Mercy. Bryan, put your DJ hat on. I know you said, and you know what? They said you thought you was a sound man. You are the sound man, because this song has a sound, and it's a kingdom sound.
Well, what song are we doing? What are we doing?
We got to play this one again. I'm going to. Yes, Lord.
Oh, man.
This is where we are.
Well, hey, this is Bryan Popin, and I might be, you know, your cousin, your brother, or someone you never even heard of. But I want this song, which is my new song, to minister to your heart like it did when God breathed it into me and this pastor friend of mine that wrote it. We're thankful for all the could have beens, the should have beens, the missed opportunities where somehow God still worked it out. But this is my brand new song. Let it minister to your soul. It's called Favor and Mercy.
Just like that.
Nah.
Thank you, Brian. We appreciate you. We will be in touch with
you
real soon.
Thank you for your time. Thanks for ministering to the people.
Yes, yes.
God bless.
How can I?
Yes.
How can I explain the way you work it out?
Bryan Popin, ladies and gentlemen.
From the beginning to the end. Thank you, God. You saved my soul from doubt. And I could have failed. I could have failed. I could have.
Too. We didn't really get a chance to talk about that, but we'll talk about it the next time. That's a talented cat, and he's been around so many. That simple song, sometimes it takes a lot of restraint when you have that much talent to just do something really simple that touches hearts like that. That song really does that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Absolutely.
It's the simple thing.
That interview was so good. We missed our check-in. Do we need to do the check-in still? I'm like, man, it's just, this is crazy.
Yeah, I think we do need to do that check-in, the morning check-in. We can't let that fly. It's 9:06 a.m. here in the capital city. It's 61 outside, a little windy, but the sun is shining. So, hey, drop your location and let us know where you are and where you're watching us or listening to us from. Come on, Bishop, work.
All right.
There it is.
Y'all heard me say it. Post your city, post your state, and let us know where you're brewing from.
They were ready already, Bishop.
Okay.
Is ready, kicking it off. We got Sister Rosa Crosby in Franklin, Louisiana. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. All right now. Hey. St. Louis, Missouri, got favor and mercy following them. That's Sister Deidre Danielle Ware. Good morning, good morning. She done covered you up, Reed.
All right, that'll work. Good morning. That's usually our lady with the scripture, Sister Brenda Duncan over in Danville, Illinois.
Good morning, Danville, Illinois. Not only that, we've got Sister Deborah Deloney, Little Rock, Arkansas, checking in, chiming in, brewing over in Little Rock. Good morning.
There she is, over at the VA in North Little Rock, Sister Tanya Russell. Good morning.
Jacksonville, Arkansas brings on, from the Mac to the Jack, Sister Ramona Thompson. Good morning, good morning.
We got power in the house, sister and mother Mary Johnson over North Little Rock, Arkansas. Good morning.
Good morning, good morning. At Lamb City Life. Excuse me. Brother Craig Ware is in the house. St. Louis, Missouri. He is in the house. Thank you, sir. Good morning, good morning.
Jordan in Ohio. Good morning. Glad to have you here.
Good morning. Good morning. Sister Cynthia Applewhite is joining us. Little Rock, Arkansas. She said, I'm good in the house. Good morning, sis.
Right out of town. I'm in Caldwell. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Lafayette, Louisiana is in the house. Mother Alma Olivier. Good morning, good morning.
Ooh,
wow.
Good morning, Brother Daniel John. Good morning.
From Kenya?
Yeah.
Wow. Good morning, sir. Columbia, South Carolina is in the house. Sister Barbara Finch. Good morning, good morning.
Turn it up. That's the turn-up queen. Sister Judy says she's here with a heart and a smile over in Hoptown, Hoptonville, Kentucky. Good morning, Sister Judy.
So glad you're here. On our way to Hopkinsville, coming up next month. Manuel Tavares is joining us from Texas. Good morning, sir. Glad to have you aboard.
Oh, wow. All right, Marilyn. Glad to have you on board this morning. Sister Emmy Masuli. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Sister Jennifer, is that Petta? Say, I'm new here. And it's very enjoyable. Where you brewing from, Sister Jennifer?
They say New York City. Pick up the pace. Good morning, Brother David. Glad to have you aboard.
Good morning, good morning. He says, I'm new also. All right, post your city, post your state, and we will celebrate you on this morning. Minister Carlos is on. Carlos Lewis, that's Mother Mary Johnson's son, brewing from North Carolina. Good morning, good morning.
All right, we got Africa in the building. Good morning.
Good morning, good morning.
Sada, good morning.
What's the name?
Nasasara Sada.
Nasasara Zala. Okay, that's a nice name. Hot Springs, Arkansas. Sister Gwen Pickney is in the house. Good morning, good morning.
All right, we got Sister Connie White from Chicago, Illinois. Good morning.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. Oh, they chiming in this morning. All right, did we get everybody? Did you post your city? Did you post your state?
Last call.
All right. Reese, it's the last call. Get it in now. All right, we appreciate all of you brewing with us on this morning. Thank you for the morning chime in. We appreciate all of you. It's the home of great gospel sounds here inside of Fred Harris and the Morning Brew. Here's a song entitled Live Your Best Life. It's the new release from Mr.
Where you at,
Fred
Coast?
Jones.
We going to the DMV.
Jesus is
to be alive, but it's best to live. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, it's good to be alive, but it's best to live. And guess what? Guess what? That's what he gave. Jesus is the Lord. Never set you free.
I know that's right. Thank you so much for chiming in on this morning. The blessings of the Lord be upon you. The sound of Brent Jones blessing us in song. Hey, we do this every morning from 8 a.m. until 10 a.m. Central Standard Time. It's Fred Harris and the Morning Brew. I'm Bishop Fred Harris.
I'm so used to saying that.
I got you that time. And you know what we do right now? We check in with birthdays and anniversaries. So, hey, if you're celebrating a birthday or an anniversary, or if you know of someone, we would love to hear from you.
We need a wish. Drop those birthdays, and it is a special, special day today. What's a special day today?
Who's celebrating a birthday on today?
I see in the comments, happy birthday to the people in our world. Elder Pastor Maurice Tatum, happy birthday today.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to Brother Craig Ware's father, Brother Gregory Ware Sr. Happy birthday, Pops.
Okay, Reed, he's on here. Maurice Tatum is on here. You got to sing it to him.
We're going to do the old school version or the new school version?
Happy birthday. Can you do it to this music? Come on.
Happy, happy birthday. Happy, happy birthday. Happy, happy birthday. And many, many more. There is my happy birthday. Happy birthday, Elder Tatum. Yeah. Happy, happy birthday. Also, happy birthday to John Green. Terrence Williams, happy birthday. And then also, happy birthday
happy
to Harry Stewart.
Very, very good. Happy birthday. Okay, wait a minute. You got your list? What about your list? Have you done your list yet?
I just did some of it. Were you listening?
Oh, that was it? That was... Okay, I thought you were reading them from post. I'm sorry.
Happy birthday to Tori Foot over in Pine Bluff. Happy birthday to Jaleesa Lisa. Happy birthday. And then happy birthday to Fred Williams. James Albert. Ricky Murphy, Redina Green, happy birthday, and happy birthday to Manziel Twilly. Happy, happy birthday.
Happy birthday to all of you from all of us here inside of Fred Harris and the Morning Brew. And wait a minute. Okay,
let's see.
Let me get my list. Here we go. Again, the pastor, the elder, Maurice Taylor. He's on the top of my list this morning. Did that sound
good? That's what I said.
Happy birthday, pastor. Sister Gwen Hatchett, that's my classmate, elementary school classmate, Gwen Hatchett, celebrating her birthday on today. Got all these pages. Got three pages. Okay. Tandia McCoy is celebrating her birthday on today. Tandia, happy birthday to you. Johnny Sampson, another classmate from Rixie, celebrating a birthday on today. Johnny Doc Sampson, happy birthday, Doc. Jeff Spry, Minister Jeffrey Spry, celebrating a birthday on today. And another one of my classmates, Mr. Terry Patton, pretty boy. You know, he had that curl back in the day. Jerry Curl, you couldn't tell him nothing. juice dripping, had that shag. Oh, he was, you couldn't tell Terry Pat nothing.
All right.
What happened? Happy birthday to Terry Patton as well on this 27th day of March 2024. Oh, March is moving on.
March is moving on. We'll be in April this weekend.
Yes.
Good Friday is on the way.
Good Friday is on the way. It's going to be, oh, it's going to be something. It's going down.
On this Witnessing Wednesday, it's already gone down, and we're going to continue to go down.
I know that's right. I know that's right. Let's have a little church, if you don't mind, just for a moment. Can we do it? Can we do it?
Let's do it.
Let's go to Chicago and bring on Ferris Evans and what he calls All of My Stuff. Goodness, all of my help coming from the Lord. The question is on this morning, when did the help start? When about what time did it start? When did
did it happen? When did it open the door and you just walked in and he began to shower you with the
It was early one morning, just about the break of day. Jesus came and he touched me and he washed my sins away. I started running, I started shouting, couldn't find no time for doubting. You know that I
got nothing but the
hope. Yes. Ooh, it was early, early one morning, just about the break of day.
My sister, bless my brother. I don't know the need.
they're going through, but I know what you brought me out of. I don't know what they said when they talked to you, but I come to talk to you, not just for myself. God bless this house. I wish I had about 5 people, but get up on your feet, won't give an authority. And say, Lord, bless this house. Lord, to pray for you, because where you were, amen, it was about to be all over. Amen. At least you had enough sense to ask him to pray, because you felt like you couldn't get a prayer through. But now you done got back and you can pray for yourself. And God said, if you talk to me right now, I'll do something for somebody else on your prayer. And even though you don't deserve it, I'm going to do it anyway.
Thank you. answer. The text, which is the subject. Finally, that's text. Think not about the thing that's singular, but things. All right, look at your neighbor and say, God's getting ready to do some things.
Come on, Zion, sing this with me.
My.
Ooh-wee.
If you believe in God for a miracle, don't wait until you get it.
Shout like you've already got it and like it's already done. Ooh, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Sometimes you got to just say it till you see it.
That's right. Man. You better say it till you see it, because we faithing it around here.
I know that's right.
Run, jump, scream, follow, whatever you got to do.
Whatever you got to do.
You got it.
Yes, Lord.
Ooh, I
yes,
know that's
Lord.
Right, Sister Ware. She said, I got a praise that won't quit.
You
bet not.
Hallelujah. Sister Brenda Duncan say, I got it running. She said, she's running.
You running. I'm right behind you. We're running. Yeah. It's been an amazing day today, Bishop.
It really has. It really has. And we're so, so thankful. That interview, I'm still feasting. I was immensely blessed. Bryan Popin.
I just love the fact that, you know, when you're in ministry and your heart is into it, it doesn't matter about all of the lights and the, you know, all this, the pomp and stance. when your heart is there, right. It shows. And I mean, you can't help, you can't hide mm-hmm. it. And his heart was right there. We felt it.
And his heart was
God's
right
chosen him
there.
To do what he's doing. And I mean, souls are being saved and people are being reminded of, you know, when they first believed. Mm-hmm. And I think being reminded of yeah. when you first believe really gives you a lot of balance. A heart check. We need that.
Absolutely.
And that's what that is, that yes. grace and mercy.
My, my. Yeah. Yes, God. You're so right. You're so right. Yes, indeed.
Well, listen, time flies when you're having fun.
Mm-hmm. It really yeah. does. 48 minutes down the hour. We got to check in and see what's going on this national day.
Yeah, let's look. Let's see what's going on the national day today. There's so many national days and international days. We're going to pick just a few, okay?
Okay. All right. Yeah.
Ooh, I like this one. It's National Little Red Wagon Day. Did you guys have little red wagons when you guys were small growing up? We had one.
Yeah,
if we weren't pulling it, we yeah. were pushing it. And if we weren't pushing it, we were riding in it or putting yeah. stuff in it, you know, going to this imaginary
barn
or something.
I remember like getting in it, like when you didn't have nobody to push you, you know, you bend that knee.
Oh, you
put
pushed
your knee
it yourself.
One leg outside, oh. you hold the handle
bless
back.
Your heart. Yeah. You, you know what? You're right. I'm telling you, those are the memories, man. It's also National Scribble Day. I'm one of those people. I am a scribbler. So I'll scribble throughout the day on, I have a piece of paper or a sticky note. I'm scribbling. I'm drawing. I'm jotting. It's National Scribble Day. And, you know, it's a form of stress relief. When you color, okay. when you scribble, when you sing, when you play, you're letting something out whenever the body wants to do something and you do it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Also today is Holy Tuesday. Well, no, because today is Wednesday. We're not doing that. You don't want that one either. It's National Day of Life, Peace, and Justice. I like that.
Life, Peace, and Justice Day. Yeah. That's good. That's good.
Yeah, let's just okay. take time just to take it all in and thank God for life. You know, this life is not always easy, but we love this life because it was given to us and it was bought and paid for with a price. And I'm thankful for it. And the peace, if you seek peace, you'll get it. Yep, mm-hmm. you'll get
yeah,
it.
Good.
And last but not least, I don't know exactly what this means, but it says National Joe. Oh, okay. National Joe. People with the name Joe, it's your day. And then it's National. Oh, no.
Yeah.
I know. That's what I said. Joe, y'all got y'all's own day. What happened my day? Where's my day? And then it's National Spanish Paella Day. I want to say that. Am I saying that right? So what is... Well, what they're saying is this is at lunchtime, workers in the fields will make the rice dish in a flat pan over a fire. They mixed in whatever they could find, like rabbits, snails, vegetables, and then they added chicken to it later, and then they would eat it for lunch. So it's a rice dish that you can add meat to. So it's called Spanish paella. Okay. I'll go for that. I like that idea. I'll just do some stir fry. Mm-hmm. Add some rice. Stir fry at rice, I know. I know that's right, all Sister right. Althea. We need that. I seek that. So what we seek, guess what? He says, seek and we shall find. And so I'm seeking peace. I'm seeking life. I'm seeking justice. And that's what I plan to find. Because I know what he said is true. That's our national days today.
Thankful for the national day, and thank you for sharing on this morning. Good morning, Sister Marie Truss. Blessings to you, Sister Althea Ricks.
wonder why my screen is jumping.
It's been jumping all day. I said maybe that's just the Holy Ghost.
Jumping all day.
You've been jumping all day. Yeah, you've been jumping like a disco over there.
I know. What is that? What is that today?
Well, the time has come, and we want everyone to be encouraged. And we do that every day. We're here Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. pushing gospel music, ministry, and more. All right, Bishop, what they got to do?
Well, we just need you to take a moment to host that word of life, that word of encouragement. What can we leave on record before we get out of here on this Witnessing Wednesday morning? It's been a phenomenal morning. What can you leave on record that others who will see this live later can be blessed by? What can you leave on record? That one word, two words, or even a few words? What say
Mine
you?
Mine would be, God is so good, and He is faithful. And He's the restorer of all things. Yep.
That's good.
Okay, I see.
Sister Brenda Duncan says, victory in the fellowship with God.
There is victory.
That's good.
Brother Craig Ware dropped you a scripture. Romans 8, 38 through 39. Yep. He going to send you that scripture. Yep. Still on that. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life nor angels nor principalities nor powers nor things present nor things to come nor height nor depth nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Yes, that's good. That's good. That's good. And his sister, Sister Deidre Ware said, old master is still working, and his name is Jesus. Yes, our master is still working, and his name is Jesus. Mother Mary Johnson, listen, just praying. I'm just praying. It's good to know, Mother Johnson, that you're praying.
God is my everything, and amen. I know that's right, Sister
Althea. Thank you, Sister Althea. Sister Marie Trust says, trust God, claim every promise, and walk in it. That's good.
Sleeping Beauty is coming through. We got she one said, more. God is so powerful when you get to know Him. Yes, He is. He's an awesome Father.
That's good. That's good. You guys have been amazing. Thank you so, so much. We appreciate all of you.
Have to go yes, out on me. Something that means a whole lot on this week before Easter. I know it was the blood.
Listen, you took the words right out of my mouth. I'm just saying. I'm like,
what?
Oh, my goodness.
And I won over yours.
I know it was the blood.
I know it was the blood. Blood. I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was lost, He died up on the cross. I know it was the blood for me. For me. And I said again, I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood.
I know it was the blood.
I know
And he did it just for me and did it just for you as well. We got to go. Listen, have a great rest of the day. Let's do it again on tomorrow on a Facebook Thursday. Love and blessings to all of you. Hey, that's Ree right there, y'all. And you are
just for me.